World Wrestling Ring Stardom is a promotion that I started watching about 9 months ago as per request by a lot of my subscribers and or followers. I first got noted of the promotion back in 2017 when the Mae Young Classic was first happening in WWE, and one of the biggest signings for the tournament was a woman by the name of Kairi Hojo. A lot of people were very excited to see her in the tournament and talked very heavily about her very famous elbow drop. Now, me being the very smarky wrestling fan that I am, I wanted to get in on what Kairi Hojo was all about before she made her WWE debut in the first ever Mae Young Classic. So I took it to YouTube to look up some Kairi Hojo matches. And the very first match I stumbled upon was her match against Io Shirai from 2015 in a promotion called Stardom. And I thought it was really good. It was different from any other female wrestling match I've ever seen up until that point. Then I remembered something. I feel like I've seen both of these women before, but I couldn't put my finger on it. Then it hit me. I've seen both of these women wrestle before in Lucha Underground against Pentagon Jr. So I've already kind of knew what they were all about, but I still wanted to dig a little bit deeper. So from that one match and a lot of more highlight packages, I got some info on Kairi Hojo going into the Mae Young Classic, and she went on to win the whole thing. And from there, I got behind her. Then came the second Mae Young Classic, and in came a woman by the name of Io Shirai, another woman which the IWC was very excited to see. Now, at the time, I didn't remember who Io was, so I thought she was someone new. I went to look her up, and then I remembered, once again, I saw her wrestle in Lucha Underground. Not only that, but I saw her wrestle Kairi in the promotion Stardom. But I looked up one of her matches, and one of those matches will be in this list. I will get to that in just a moment. But one can really thank Kairi Sane and Io Shirai for introducing me into the Joshi wrestling scene, and almost in a way segueing me into Stardom, a promotion that I really, really love. And at a time right now when Stardom has lost so much, from Kagetsu to Hazuki to Arisa, and now the passing of Hana Kimura, I think now more than ever we should be giving some light to the world of Stardom. And for that matter, I'm going to be listing for you guys my top 5 favorite Stardom matches, some that you should look out for if you're interested in getting into Stardom, or you may have never watched Joshi Wrestling a day in your life and you want to see what it's all about. But that being said, let's get into number 5. When I first started trying to get into Stardom, this was one of the first matches I watched. Already knowing the name Bea Priestley and being attracted to Hana's vibe, I was enticed for this match. But given I wasn't familiar with either woman's work, I didn't set my expectations too high. I know Bea Priestley often gets a bad rep from keyboard warriors about being one of the least interesting in-ring performers in Stardom, and while I don't think she's necessarily a terrible wrestler like many claim her to be, I much rather prefer her tag team partner Jamie Hayter in a match over her any day. However, I think this is, at least to my consumption, Bea's best match to date. Lots of great mat work from Bea Priestley that I think really showcased her strengths in the ring. I know this is quite a bit high praise for Bea, but don't think I forgot about our pink-haired queen Hana Kimura. Because on the opposing side, Hana, who among other things was portraying a babyface in this match, did a damn good job at building anticipation for her moves and selling the offense of Bea, whether in submission or through power moves. Her sequence in this match was among her best work, and it really encapsulated me in wanting to see her win more than any other match I've seen her in. Because Hana, for a lot of her time in Stardom, was portrayed as either a heel or a tweener, whether it be her time in Oedo Tai or as the leader of Tokyo Cyber Squad. In this match, she was able to get the crowd behind her through gestures and body language, and for that matter, she did a damn great job. Though defeated, Hana went out leaving the impression that she is very worthy of a top spot in Stardom. After the match, we saw the Stardom debut of one of their newest faction leaders and acquisitions, Julia, who went on to lead Dino Del Mundo. From here, Julia would be Hana's final rival in Stardom before her sad departure from all of us. For all of you who may not be aware, Hana Kimura committed suicide on May 23rd of this year, in a day that crushed the wrestling community. And though we will never be able to see her perform in a live capacity again, her memory will forever live through matches like these, where her potential really shows. Rest in peace, Hana. You'll be greatly missed. And when you come across Shad Gaspard up there in Wrestle Heaven, please give him a hug for us. We miss him too. When the second Mae Young Classic was announced, one female wrestler that was announced for the tournament that had a lot of buzz surrounding her was Io Shirai. Not much surprise that she comes from the same Stardom promotion as Kairi Sane, who won the tournament last year. Now, as I said earlier, I've seen her wrestle twice at this point, once against Pentagon Jr. and the other against Kairi Hojo in Stardom in 2015. But I wanted to dig a little deeper before her debut in WWE, and one of the first matches I came across was her versus Momo Watanabe at Stardom Gold Star 2018, and the match simply kicked a lot of ass. Like a lot of Japanese Puro matches, the first act started off with slow build and with mat wrestling from both women, and made its way into stiff kicks from Momo and incredible speed and persistence from Io. And as the match went on, I was thinking to myself, wow, this Io chick is so clean with her moves. Her bridges are precise, her acrobatics are accurate, and any move she had hit on her is met with an endurance-filled no-sell or a show of pain that you truly bought into. And I can't possibly forget about Momo, who threw a very valiant effort at Io in this match. She truly did come off as a rookie in comparison, but by no slouch, she truly put on an unforgettable babyface performance. And as the match went on, it increasingly got more high impact with their sequences and more intense with every dramatic near fall. Momo put down Io and won the prestigious right strap in what was not only a passing of the torch in the sense of the championship, but as the leader of Queen's Quest and future ace of the promotion. This match is one of my earliest memories of Stardom before I actually got into the promotion last year, and it is a match I will always remember as one that not only introduced me into Momo Watanabe, but one that really rallied me behind Io as one of NXT's top prospects in the coming future. The match only went 10 minutes, but was a true testament to what the art of pro wrestling really is. There's something about Stardom's cinematic camera shots and poetic facial expressions from these women on the roster that really makes their matches stand out a lot more to me than any other women's match I see in the States nowadays. And this match is a prime example of that. As I stated in a previous video, wrestling fans nowadays are so caught up in the stigma of 5-star matches going at least 30 minutes and must meet a direct criteria they formed themselves or by one man's opinion for a match to be considered great. This match went a third of that time and easily got across the message of it being one of the most vital matches in the career of Tam Nakano, while at the time was crucial in the ending moments of Kagetsu, this being her last documented singles match in Stardom, a promotion that has been a mainstay for her for the last 5 years, and in that 5 years, joining a faction, Oedo Tai, which she later became the leader of, and in time, recruiting Tam Nakano to that faction. This would be the start of Tam's career, before soon branching off into Stars after losing a match that ended in her relinquishing her spot in Oedo Tai. With that tone set, these women went out there and made every move count, and every kick out meant something. It's something you would have to watch yourself in order to get what I mean by that. Tam Nakano winning with her new finisher Twilight Dream and breaking into tears after the match was just icing on the cake. You really believe this match meant something for Tam, even if you're a new viewer and know nothing about the history between both women. Tam hopping on a microphone and thanking Kagetsu for casting her out of Oedo Tai 2 years ago so she can finally become the woman she is now is really a beautiful sentiment in how stories can be greatly executed in professional wrestling. Check this match out. It's short and sweet with a satisfying ending that felt like the true closing chapter to Kagetsu and the beginning of a new for Tam Nakano. I get misty just holding your hand. Here's a match that changed on one day's notice after Mayu's original opponent, Suri, came down with an injury that deemed her unable to compete. And in her place came Takumi Iroha. Now mind you, I'm fresh into the Joshi wrestling scene, so I don't know what a Takumi Iroha is, let alone her home promotion Marvelous. So I got into this match once again with low expectations. Not even 5 minutes deep into this match, Takumi takes Mayu on the outside of the ring, hoists her on her shoulders in the cradle position, and throws her into the ring post. God damn. That was some meta shit you normally don't see start off a match in any promotion with any gender in any setting, but this one was really one that got you interested right off the bat. As the match went on, you got not only a showcase of Takumi and her massive arsenal of moves she has from a wide range of kicks to high angle suplexes to some great grapple wrestling, but it also truly showed off just how outstanding of an underdog Mayu Iwatani is. From her incredible ragdoll-like selling ability to her capability to work from the ground up with really any opponent she's in the ring with, no matter if it's offense or defense. These two, who I'm unfamiliar with the history of, crafted a match that I believe was a match of the year candidate for 2020. The premise of this match was built on both women wanting to execute a move taught to them by their trainer. While Takumi uses it on a regular basis, Mayu has either rarely hit it or has yet to hit it. So the story of this match going into it was a big driving factor into the finish. Counter after counter, after Mayu tried her very hardest, Takumi actually ends up hitting the move to pin her. Not only beating the World of Stardom champion and the ace of the promotion, but doing it in Mayu's own territory. To me, a new fan, this is a marvelous way, to establish a future main player in Iroha if they ever get the chance to get her back to Stardom for a rematch. This is a match I think anyone who's never seen a Joshi match should consider checking out. It really was a great performance and one I won't soon forget. And that gets me into my favorite Stardom match thus far. Ah yes, a match that was truly existential to not only my love for both women, but what really sold me on the promotion as a whole. Upon getting requests from many viewers of what matches I should check out, one common trend I got often was Ariso Shiki vs. Tam Nakano. Now at the time, I was maybe a few weeks into actually watching Stardom, day by day, and I still had a lot of names to learn. Ariso at the time was the Wonder of Stardom champion, and labeled as one of Stardom's finest and future world champions. And Tam Nakano, the violent Kung Fu Yandere, that has potential but hasn't really had that breakout performance to put on a map just yet. With only that information to go off and not the 7 months of build-up leading into this match, I was ready for this. And this match was amazing. The constant battle of control in the very beginning set a great tone and a true power struggle between these two as to exactly who would be the one to admit to defeat. And as per usual in a lot of matches, through facial expressions, it can easily be conveyed that this match meant a lot to Tam, much more than just a championship match. And as for Arisa, she's kind of just tired of being disrespected by Tam for something she feel like she didn't do to her. From swift submission counters to crazy springboards to stiff kicks, these two women went out there and they put on a classic. The part that really stands out for me in this match was when we get to that 15-minute mark, when the elbow exchanges started to come and they were met with suplexes, high impact moves, and some of the cleanest knee strikes you'll ever see. One spot that really sticks out to me more than any other is when Arisa hit a V-trigger-like knee onto Tam Nakano that dazes her and dramatically causes her to fall onto both knees. Arisa then follows this up with another running knee that was hit so perfectly and met with one of the best sell jobs I've ever seen that it really put me over the top and burned into my head what Stardom is really all about. Even the finish was well done in my opinion. Arisa hitting her finishing move, the Brazilian kick, onto Tam. But while Tam was out of it, she didn't fall. It was almost as if she was doing everything in her power to stay alive even though she had nothing left to give. It's pretty reminiscent of that scene you see in movies where there's a fight between two men and one guy obviously wins the fight, but the guy on the ground that's basically about to die is crawling, trying his very best to get one more punch in before he dies and he just kind of collapses. That's what that spot reminded me of. Cinematic art. Arisa had to literally tackle her to the mat in order to get her to fall and get the pin. After the match, Arisa went in for a handshake, but Tam shoved it away, grabbing Arisa's head in a very nurturing manner, both breaking into tears and embracing one another. And that really put it over the top for me, and it became one of my favorite women's matches ever. Arisa Oshiki is now retired from in-ring competition, and it greatly saddens me as she was my favorite wrestler in Stardom. The retirement was due to injury, she had a lot more to give, but ultimately she has to put her health first. It does open up the discussion for whether Tam Nakano should be first in line for a Wonder of Stardom championship shot, but that will be a discussion for another video. That being said, it's matches like these that truly make Stardom like no other promotion I've ever seen. The emotion and vulnerability these women allow themselves to show on camera really adds so much layer and depth into their movements in and out of the ring. For that matter, WWRS is one of my favorite promotions to watch at the moment. And I hope all of you really enjoyed this video and got some idea at least for what I perceive to be some of Stardom's best work and something I think you all should check out in your spare time. You guys can show your support in the comment section down below by commenting what is your favorite Joshi match, your favorite Stardom match, or something you like about the promotion. Comment down below, let us all know. Hit that like button, subscribe, and definitely check out Stardom World if you have the time. Love you guys as always, and I will talk to you all later. Peace out, guys.